Sometimes you have a form that collects information that will live in multiple places, or in this case, multiple tables within an Airtable database. In this example, I'm going to be showing you how to collect a sales transaction for a particular client, all of that information from one form, but we're going to break it out and put it into different tables through an automation. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and I'm with Gap Consulting, a company that helps you to organize and automate your business and life. So if that's of interest and you want to learn more about how we do that, check out the links below in the description of this video and get some more information. Now, before we get into the heart of the video, I do want to invite you to join me on my upcoming live webinar. Once a week, I hop into a live webinar. We record the power of automation, and my goal is to help you understand how to leverage automation to help you reclaim your time. We go through this process that we call building a second brain for your business. It allows you to run so much of your business on autopilot so that you can focus on the stuff that really matters. So if that's of interest and you want to learn more about how we automate up to 20 hours per person per week, check out the link below or visit me at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration and go ahead and sign up for that training. Even if you can't attend, you'll get the replay in your mailbox. So without further ado, let's hop into the heart of this video. We are talking about using JotForm to collect a lot of information that is spread out over several tables. So let's start by checking out the form that we've built. And this is actually a copy of a form that I literally use in running Gap Consulting. So quick backstory here, people can book an hour of time with a consultant that is part of our team. But sometimes they want to prepay a bundle of hours. They want to buy 10 hours or more. And as a thank you for prepaying that many hours, we're going to give them a bit of a discount on those hours. And so we've built this form that allows them to select 10 sessions at once. Of course, they have to give their company information and their name. This is, of course, the name and email address here and the company name of the person who wants to receive the consultation. And then that's different from the person who's actually paying, because a lot of times you'll use a credit card perhaps that your boss has or something along those lines, where it's not necessarily the same person paying every time. So in this example, we're collecting all of this data, but this information, the company name, the primary point of contact name, the primary email, that's all contact data. But then this part of the form is the sales part of the form. And so this is a form that we cannot build in Airtable by itself, because Airtable forms only create a record in one table. So we need to use JotForm or another more advanced form software that can allow us to do all these more advanced things, including taking payments. Now, I've shown in a previous video how you can take payments with JotForm. So if you haven't quite learned that yet, do check out that video and learn how to integrate Stripe or PayPal or any other payment processor with your JotForm account so that you can take payment in that form. Now, normally for us, this is simply a $1,500 transaction. But in this case, because I'm testing an automation, I want to give a test example that of course is free so that I don't have to put in credit card information in order to get this to work. So once you've built your form, the first step is to make sure that you have your database structured properly. In this case, I'm dealing with client information. So I have a table for clients. And on that table, at a minimum, I'll want the first name, the last name, and the email address. I could also bring in company name or some additional information if I so choose. Then this table is going to link to sales. Sales is a different type of data that I'm collecting. In the sales table, I need to collect the amount of each sale individually, the date that the sale came into existence, and who purchased the item or items that we sold. So I hope you can see how there is a related relationship here. The client connects to the sale, but they're not the same set of data. So we need two different tables for this information. So now, inside of our automation, once we are ready to perform automation, we can go into Zapier, and to start, we will initiate this automation with a catch hook. Now, if you're new to webhooks, they can be a bit intimidating, but it's really straightforward. All we're going to do here is choose a trigger event of catch hook. We're going to then take that catch hook Zapier produces a URL for us, and we need to integrate this with our JotForm so that as soon as a new form is submitted in JotForm, it instantly sends that data to Zapier and triggers our automation at the same time. So in order to do this, we just need to copy the catch hook that was provided for us, and we're going to go into our form settings. So back into JotForm, go to settings, click on to your integrations area, and simply look for the webhook option. Inside of here, all you need to do is edit your integration or add that webhook. So once you've copied and pasted it, complete the integration. It'll tell you that it's going to take a few moments. It happens really quickly. And now JotForm is going to pass that information to Zapier to trigger the automation as soon as a new form is submitted. Now, we need to fill out some sample data in the form so that we have something to play with. So let's go to our form and publish it. Open up this form in a new tab, and we can put in some fake information. In this case, I'll say Gap Consulting, fill out my name, my email address, and I have to choose what I want to purchase here. Now, of course, the second choice here is only available right now because I don't want to actually pay myself $1,500. So I'm going to click test, and I can put in some sample data. Now, if you're testing out a payment and you want to use some example Visa information, you can just put in all 4242s, make up whatever CCV you'd like, and make sure that you pick an expiration date in the future. So in this case, I'll say 8/21, for example. Now, this is obviously just a test transaction, so I don't need to worry about this, and this is a test number that I can use to test that automation. I'll click submit. It takes me to the thank you page, and I now have some sample data that I can play with in setting up my automation. I'll head back to Zapier now, and I'll test that trigger. Now, this is a test I pulled in earlier, so I'm going to need to reload some additional information, and sure enough, you see that just 0 seconds ago, new information came in from JotForm. So I can look at this, and you'll see the information that I just filled out for that piece. Now we can move on to the next step. The next step here is going to be finding or creating the client record. Now again, remember, the hard part here is that we have data living in two separate tables. We've got clients and I've got my sales. So first I need to find the client if they already exist. But if they don't, I need to create that client record in Airtable. So let's set up the find or create client. We choose the Airtable app here. We choose the event of finding a record. Of course, map it to your proper Airtable account. And then map it to your database. In this case, I've called my database JotForm Payment. Map it to your clients table or whatever table is relevant for you to find. And then you need to tell it how you're going to identify if this client already exists in your system. In this case, I'm going to use email because email is always unique. So I will look for the email field in Airtable and I will see if I can find an email that matches the email that we received when our form was submitted. If I find that record, then fantastic. This automation step is finished and it's going to move on. It will identify the record that it found and go on to the next step. But if I cannot find it, I need to make sure I create that record. In order to do that, I need to check the box, create Airtable record, and I need to fill out as much information about that client as I know. In this case, I'll fill out the first name, I'll fill out the last name, and I'll create it, of course, with the email address. So let's go ahead and give this step a test. This is our second step. We can go ahead and test it, and we'll see that, in fact, it is able to find a matching record. We see that here. Zap data was found, true, and it says, yes, we found the record of Gareth that already exists in this database. However, if it did not already exist, at least this email address, then it would create a new one. Now, moving on to the final step of the automation, we're going to create the sale record. So in our sales table, we link to the client, we know the date of the sale, and this is found using the created time, so we don't actually need to add any information here. As soon as the record is created, we know when that was. So all we really need to worry about then is client and the amount of the sale. So in this final step, we're going to again choose the app Airtable. We're going to use the action event of creating a record. And when we go to set up that, we're going to, of course, choose our database again, and then to the proper table, in this case, our sales table. And we only need to put data into two places, the amount of the sale and what the client is. Now, since we're linking to a record here, we want to make sure that we find the record that we found or created in step two, and we bring it in using the record ID. So use that record ID, not the visible name of the record, but the ID will always get you better results because the ID is always unique. And then here again in the amount, we're going to just add in the amount of the sale. So that information came in from the form. We can go down and scroll to, in this case, raw request, payment total, checksum. That brings in that zero, and I can test this step as well. And we will see that it then creates a new record here with the current timestamp, the proper amount, and the client. So now that we've got this all working, let's turn the automation on and we're gonna test it with a new client, right? We wanna make sure that our automation works from all sides, and we've already proven step by step that it works if the client already exists in the database, but what if they don't? So we're gonna create a new one here. I will open the form yet again and submit some new information. Now I've created this contact here with an example email address that does not already exist, and let's just verify that, does not already exist in our client's table. I'm gonna make sure that I select the free option and I'll provide some credit card information here. Again, I can use all four twos here to get a fake credit card that I can use for automation testing purposes, and then I can make sure to get an expiration that is in the future. Once I click submit, Zapier should do all its magic in the background, and I can go into my database and I see that already I have a new client here created, and we see that a new sale was recorded in the amount of $0 that is linked to that client, and everything seems to be working properly. So this is a great example of how you can use JotForm in order to capture data that lives in multiple tables and split it up and connect all of the moving parts properly using an advanced automation. I hope you got a ton of value out of this video. If you did, be sure to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel if you want to learn more about building without code, and I'll see you in the next video. As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly. And we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.